हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधु जगत पते, गोपेशे गोपीकांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी, विषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। भक्त्या विहीनाय अपराध लक्षे, क्षिप्तस्य कामादि तरंग मध्ये, कृपामयी तं शरणं प्रपन्न वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदम। वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदम। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद
Oh, you
श्री
moved by the audio
अद्वैत
call in the five Zoom.
शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदा। एवरीवन टुगेदर, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। माय प्रणाम्स ओबेसेंसेस टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय गुरु महाराज नित्य लीला प्रभु विष्णु विष्णु पार स्तोत्र शत भक्ति प्रमोद पुरी गोस्वामी महाराज, एंड सिमिलरली टू माय शिक्षा गुरुदेव नित्यलीला विष्णु विष्णुपाद भक्ति वेदांत शिला नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज, नित्यलीला विष्णु विष्णुपाद भक्ति विज्ञान शिला भारती गोस्वामी महाराज। माय दंडवत प्रणाम्स टू शिला भक्ति सिद्धांत शास्त्री ठाकुर प्रभुपाद एंड टू ऑल हिज एसोसिएट्स। सिमिलरली माय ओबेसेंसेस टू श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु एंड ऑल हिज एसोसिएट्स एंड टू श्री श्री राधा माधव। सो सून few weeks back we and all devotees around the world observed Krishna Janmashtami, and we already spoke on some Krishna Tattva, but now everyone is following Radha Ashtami, means preparing themselves to follow Radha Ashtami. Radha Ashtami was one of the favorite festival of Srila Gurudev. Many temples around the world, they don't follow Radha Ashtami. They only concentrate on Krishna Janmashtami. They are more fond of Krishna, which is true. We all have to be, but we belong to Shri Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya, and the speciality of this Shri Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya, in which Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also took this Sampradaya, and Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada elaborated the details of why Mahaprabhu chose this Sampradaya and what is the speciality of Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Yeah, all these questions all centered to Radha Rani. And that's why very soon, next week, after a few days, we're going to follow Shri Radha Ashtami, the appearance of Radha Rani. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Keval Madhav Puje So Agyani. In his bhajan, Shri Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, anyone who worships Madhav alone is unknowledgeable person. He's agyani. He has no complete understanding and knowledge. Yeah. But if you see, if you go temples and if you speak to any ordinary person, I mean the materialistic person, they will say, what is the need of Radha? Krishna is everything. He's Supreme Lord. But Gaudiya Vaishnavas, they give more emphasis on Radha Rani. They give more importance to Radha Rani than Krishna. This is Gaudiya. That's why it's called Gaudiya Sampradaya. So let us hear some of the glories of Radha Rani today. And I'm going to add something, but I want to take shelter of one of our acharyas in this line who was very prominent and used to speak so much about Radha Rani. Of course, we heard a lot from Srila Gurudev, And many, many details are there. It cannot be even complete in just 1 hour of Harikatha. Yeah. But I was just scrolling down my computer and I saw Srila Gaur Govind Goswami Maharaj, whose tithi we just followed, the whole world has followed. He wrote something very special on Sri Radha Tattva. And that made me thought of this 2 days back, that when we're going to start this conference, Harikatha, we will going to hear from what Srila Gaur Govind Goswami Maharaj has to speak about Radha Tattva. So Sri Radha Rani Ki Jai. Srila Maharaj said, Radha Rani, Radha Tattva, how one can understand Radha Tattva? Only if someone first have to understand what is Gaur Tattva, Gauranga Tattva, can understand fully what is the importance of Radha Rani. Krishna being Supreme Personality of Godhead, blackish complexion. But what made him so restless that he has to beg for, you know, what Krishna did, beg, borrow and steal. This is what Gurudev used to say. You should be greedy for bhakti, not greedy for any other object. And if you're greedy for bhakti, then you have to beg, borrow or steal whatever you want. Krishna also did like this. He begged, borrowed and steal. He's very famous thief of Braj. Srila Gurudev used to say this. Braje prasiddham navanita choram. He's very famous thief that he steals butter. He also stole the cloths of the gopis. But he went very far to even stealing the complexion of Radharani and the mood, internal mood of Radharani. He stole this. I'm going to explain this later, how he stole this. Very amazing pastime. But he also begged for this. Where he begged? Srimad Bhagavatam 10th Canto, at the almost at the end of Rasa Leela, Krishna folded his hands and he said, Na pareham nirvadya samyujam susadu kritta vibuddhi yosha pipa. O gopis, O Radharani, I cannot repay your debt. I cannot repay your debt. Your love is so high. Okay? I want to see, I want to also taste this love. What is that present in you which is not present in me? I want to taste this love of Radharani. So he begged. He begged, and Gurudev said he also borrowed. What he said? Krishna said, I'm just repeating the word of Srila Gurudev. Krishna begged for Radharani and said, not many years, but just for 48 years, give me your complexion and give me your moods. Radhaji said, what are you going to do with this? Krishna said, I want to taste this. I want to relish this. What is that present in your heart which is locked? Because Radharani is so chaste, she never opened and revealed her love to anyone. She always hiding her love. Always hiding that love. She don't want anyone else to even know this. That's why only Radharani can please Krishna the most. No one else. Only Radharani. And therefore, one of our Acharya, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, explains in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, uh, that verse. Ekam Radhika Nacha Anyam Ka Krishna Pranay Janibu Shrimati Radhika Eka Ka Asya Presya Anupam Guna Radhika Eka Nacha Anyam. He said, what is the origin, the birth of Krishna's prem, Krishna's love? He said, only Radharani. Ka Krishnasya Prane Janibu Shrimati Radhika Eka. Only Radharani is the source of the love of Krishna. Ka Asya Presam Anupam Guna Radhika Eka Nachanyam. Who has the most qualities? He said, only Radharani has the most qualities. Nobody else. Therefore, Krishna Vancha Puri Kare Kare Aradhana. Krishna, Radharani satisfy Krishna the most with her dedication. That's why her name is Radhika. What is the meaning of Radhika? In 10th canto, Srimad Bhagavatam Rasalila, Shude Goswami explained this. Anne Radhito Nunam Bhagwan Hari Vishwara Yanno Vihaya Govinda. What is saying? That this particular gopi has worshipped Krishna the most. That's why her name is Radha. Aradhika. Aradhika means Radha. But our acharyas commenting on this said, no, this is not correct. According to Ras Vichar, it should be that Krishna has served one gopi, that particular one gopi the most. That's why her name is Radhika. Not that Radharani served Krishna the most and that her name is Radhika. But Krishna has served and worshipped that gopi the most. That's why Radhika. So there are so many topics regarding this. So let us hear what Shri Gaur Govind Goswami Maharaj has to explain about. He said, first of all, you have to understand the Gaur Tattva. Then he said, what is the reason of the advent of Prem Purushottam Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Why Mahaprabhu descended? And Maharaj explains, there are two types of cause for Mahaprabhu to come. One is external and other is internal cause. What is external cause? Both a Yuga Dharma Parvartanam Hai Nama Sankirtan, to establish the Yuga Dharma, that is Nama Sankirtan. And other is Prema Dan. Anarpitam Charim Chirat Karunya Avatin Kalo Samarpetam Unnatujarasam Savakti Shriyam Harihipura Sundar Duti Kadam Vasandipita Sada Hride Kandreshu Surithave Sachinandana. Prema Dan. To give prem, love of Krishna. Krishna himself wants to give his love to everyone, but he as Krishna cannot give. But when he comes as Mahaprabhu, taking the form, the complexion of Radharani, and then is this distributing this prema to everyone. And how is distributing? Patra apatra vicharam na kurute na cha param vikshate. Without considering one who is qualified or not qualified. Is it proper time or not time? If someone is mine or not mine, no consideration of any kind. And Mahaprabhu freely is distributing, is giving this love to each and everyone. Yeah, this is the cause of Mahaprabhu to come. So these external causes are meant for living entities of Kali Yuga. But the internal cause is for himself. Krishna is enjoyer. Shastra scripture says, Raso Vaisa. He enjoys all the rasas. Akhil Rasamrit Murti. He is the embodiment of all the rasas. So, he also wants to relish this. And in his relishing this, the whole world, the whole universe got benefited. This is Gaur Tattva. So external cause is spreading what? Yug Dharma means establishing Yug Dharma, the Dharma of Iron Age, Kali Yuga, by giving Nam Sankirtan. But the internal cause is for him, himself, his own. The internal cause is for himself. The external cause is the need of others, whereas the internal cause is the Krishna's own need. See how beautifully Srila Gaur Govind Goswami Maharaj explains this. So nice to read and to speak and to even hear this. It's soothing for the ears and also giving, you know, such good impressions. External cause, Nam Sankirtan, is for others, is a need of others. They need this. Why they need this? In the song we sing this. Enechi Aushadhi Maya Nashivar Lagi Hari Nama Maha Mantra Laho Tumi Magi Hari Nama Maha Mantra Laho Tumi Magi. See what he's saying. Mahaprabhu saying, Enechi Aushadhi Maya, I brought the right medicines for all of you in this material world who are afflicted with this disease of birth and death, birth and death. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. Again and again, I brought this medicines for all of you. Yeah? What is that? Hari nama maha mantra laho tumi magi. Hari nama maha mantra. This maha mantra, Hare Krishna maha mantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram. This is what Mahaprabhu brought from spiritual world. Because this holy name, this Naam, this name is the only wealth which prevails in Golok Vrindavan. Only this is the wealth. How? Golokera prema dhana Hari nama sankirtana. Golokera prema dhana. The wealth of Golok is prem. There is nothing beyond prem there, which cross all other etiquettes. Prema is so high. Prema is very high. Yesterday someone asked me a question. There was one person. He said, Maharaj, is devotion is superior or prema is superior? So that was a very elaborate subject actually. I spoke for a while. But just in essence is devotion is superior or prema is superior? I said, prema is superior. And to attain that prema, we need devotion. He said, no, we need prema to get devotion. I said, no, we need devotion to get prema. Because what is the goal of our life? To attain Krishna is the goal of our life. No, no, no. Krishna is already attainable. And what we want is Krishna prema. Sadhe, that's a sadhe, that's a goal. Krishna prema is the goal of life. So we need devotion to achieve that Krishna prema. And what is that devotion? That devotion means dedication. And what is dedication? Dedication means surrenderness. I surrender to you, I dedicate to you. And then what is the meaning of surrenderness? Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains. The meaning of surrenderness means anukulasya sankalpam pratikulasya vivarjanam rakshiti iti vishvaso goptitya varnam tatha atmanikshepa karpanya. Accepting those things which are favorable to bhakti, rejecting all those things which are unfavorable to bhakti. Third, only believing Krishna is my protector. And conviction that Krishna is my maintainer. Self-surrenderness and humility. These are six limbs of surrenderness. Shadanga sharanagati hai vejahar tahar pratna sune Shinand Kumar. If anyone follows in whatever degree the six limbs of sharanagati, in the same proportion, Krishna will hear their prayers. Same proportion. Because Krishna says, ye yatha mam pravadante tam sate bhajame ham. You worship me in whatever degree, I reciprocate you in the same proportion. So, now very important question for all devotees around the world. Everyone has some faith, some Shraddha. Everyone chant holy name. Everyone chant the Diksha mantras. Everyone, some or the other, put water in Tulasi. With the eyes, glorifying, adoring the beauty of the deities. Following Ekadashi. Everything is positive. We are doing every day in our daily practices. Yeah. But something we are lacking. Something we are lacking, and this is a missing link. What is that lacking? Giving up all those things which are unfavorable to bhakti. When this point comes, you know, we are very weak. Hide durbalyam. Very hard to give up those things which are unfavorable to bhakti because of our addictions. Addictions to what? Yeah. Addictions to what? Addictions to lust, anger, greed, envious. Yeah. Addiction to this. And we are surrounded by all these negativities around us, which is holding us to not able to complete the process of sharanagati, surrenderness. And because of that, there is always some lacking in devotion. And because there is lacking in devotion, we can't touch this point of prema, which is the ninth step, starting from, as Rupa Goswami Pad explains, Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Anarth Nivritti, Nishta, Ruchi, Asakti, Bhav and Prem. Sri Vishnu Chakur Thakur explains this. Very detailed. So, patra patra vicharam na kurote. I'm giving some details. Without any consideration, Mahaprabhu has spreaded this, gave this. Otherwise, today, how we, so sinful people, always indulge in sinful activities. How we are today chanting this Mahamantra, even though not purely, but still we are hearing about Mahaprabhu, we are hearing about Radharani, we are observing Radhashtami. How we are doing this? Mahaprabhu's mercy, the compassion of Mahaprabhu. But when I'm saying Mahaprabhu, that means all the family of Mahaprabhu, all the associates of Mahaprabhu, all the way from Mahaprabhu till Gurudev. This is the family. Mahaprabhu is the cause for this. So this is external cause. External cause is the need of others. Whereas internal cause of Mahaprabhu to come in this world is Krishna's own need. He also needs something. Oh, Krishna also needy? Didn't we heard that Krishna is Atma Ram, Atma Kam? That means he is self-satisfied. He dwells in his own pleasure. Yes, he do. But still, he's lacking there. He's incomplete there. And what is that incompleteness? He wants to relish this. He wants to taste this. I'm incomplete and I want to become complete. So this is the need of Krishna. He wants to fulfill this need. And it's not only one. There are three needs of Krishna. Three. Yeah. Like we also have three needs. Hari, Guru, वैष्णव तेनेर स्मरण तेनेर स्मरण है विघ्न विनाशन अन्य सपावे निज वांछित पूरण ओ कृष्णा ओ गुरुदेव वी हैव थ्री नीड्स व्हाट इज दैट फॉर द सर्विस ऑफ हरि सर्विस ऑफ गुरु एंड सर्विस ऑफ वैष्णव थ्री नीड्स वी ऑल्सो एंड दैट्स वाई हरि नाम इज ऑल्सो प्रोनाउंस थ्री टाइम्स हरेर नाम हरेर नाम हरेर नाम एव केवलम three times. So Krishna also have three desires. Shri Radha Pranay Mahima Kidrisho Vaniva Swadhyena Adbhut Madhurima Kidrisho Vamadiya Sokhyam Chasyam Mad Anubhavita Kidrisham Veti Lobad Tad Bhavadaya Samajani Sachi Garbha Sindhu Harindu. What is the meaning of this shloka? In Chaitanya Charitamrita. Desiring to understand the glory of Radharani's love, the wonderful qualities in him that she alone relish through her love. She alone relish. No one can love, relish to that point as Radharani can relish the love. Only she. Therefore, Modan Madan Madanakhya Mahabhav, the topmost Mahabhav, only Radharani relished this. So, this is one. Other is, the happiness she feels when she relished the sweetness of his love. What is that happiness? Krishna wants to taste this. Yeah. The Supreme Lord Hari, richly endowed with her emotions, appeared from the womb of Shachi Mata, as the moon appeared from the ocean. The analogy is given. What is the origin of moon? In Srimad Bhagavatam, when there is churning of ocean, the moon appeared from the ocean. From the churning of ocean, the moon appeared. The moon appeared. Similarly, Sachi Mata womb is considered as ocean. And Mahaprabhu is like Chandra, Gaur Chandra. That's God Chandra appeared from the ocean-like womb of Sachi Mata. So why in this whole verse, it is, you could have said something else, but why it is mentioned that that Mahaprabhu who appeared from the womb of Mother Sachi, why? To show that mother always have unconditional affection for their children. Sachi Mata has so much affection for Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sri Yashoda Mai has so much affection for Krishna. So much affection. Her prema surpasses all other restrictions. The prema of Mahaprabhu, the prema of Sachi Mata surpass all the prema. The embodiment of Vatsalya Rasa. So while chanting this verse, there's a mood behind this is that Mahaprabhu who is the son of Sachi Mata means that affection which Sachi Mata have for Mahaprabhu, when this affection will reflect on me from Mahaprabhu. You know, this is like a kind, this is the style of praying, how we have to pray. Don't pray directly to the Krishna, to Mahaprabhu. Pray through some of the associates of Mahaprabhu. Some of the associates of Krishna. Pray from their point of angle. Because our prayers might be wrong. We don't know so much. But following the footsteps of this associates, prayers are always full of greed. Greed is not a positive word. We are told to give up all greeds. So, what is the message? To get divide off all the greeds? No. Anya vilashita shunyam. Not anya vilash shunyam. Try to understand this. Very detailed topic. We are told not to keep any greed in the heart. But we are also not told to not keep any greed in the heart. We have to keep some greeds in the heart. We should not be empty, zero, or void of any greed. No, that's not our sampradaya. This is the mood of other some sampradayas, Mayavadis. Gaudiya Vaishnava sampradaya, full of greeds. You see the whole song book, the bhajans by Narottam Thakur, all the songs by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, songs by Lochan Das Thakur, full of greeds. But what kind of greed? The positive ones. Gauranga bolite have pulaka sharira hari hari bolite na yane bave nira hari hari bolite na yane bave nira ar kabe nitai chande करुणाहिबे संसार वसान मोरा कबे तू चाहबे. So much greed. When the day we come in my life, when I chant the name of Gauranga and I get shivering, the hair stands on my end. When the day will come, when the mercy of Nityam Prabhu will fall on me, that I will try to understand that all these sense objects which is entangling me is the cause of my entangled in this material world. When the day will come. Kabe habe bolo se dina amar aparada guchi shudana meruchi. See, in this bhajan also. Yeah. When the day will come in my life, when I'm able to chant pure holy name. So everywhere, all the songs, books are full of greed. So if we have to understand what is the definition of greed, we have to hear from our acharyas, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Lochan Thakur, Narottam Thakur. This is the ideal greed we need to develop. And that's why there is a need, essential, we should sing this bhajans, or we should know, read the meaning. And by reading the meaning, when we sing the bhajans, there's some emotions which softens the heart, which is very hard right now. It will soften the heart, and then dedication comes all the level to achieve the prema. This is a procedure. Yeah, so we are hankering. Right now we are longing and hankering and praying to Gurudev and all acharyas to please help us to develop this greed. And Narottam Thakur says, Lobh sadhu sange hari katha. We have this body and inherited with so many negativities, and one of them is greed, lobha. But Narottam Thakur explaining how we have to engage this greed in the service of Krishna. Then he said, Narottam Thakur says, Lobh sadhu sange hari katha. We should be greedy to hear hari katha from the sadhus. Hari katha, wherever, beg, borrow and steal. Just go and associate with sadhus. What is the meaning of association? Oh, I am hearing Hari Katha every Sunday, 2 hours, and I am associating. Yes, it's kind of association, no doubt. But not actual association. Only hearing Hari Katha is not association. And then what is the meaning of association? Adopting someone's lifestyle in one's lifestyle is called association. I saw something good in you. I saw some good car with you. I develop a greed. I also want to drive this car. I also want to become like this person. So adopting someone's lifestyle in one's lifestyle is called association, and that's the reason we associate with so many materialistic people around us. Moment we see them, we try to adopt their lifestyle. Yeah, this is the problem. Adopting lifestyle is called association. So when we adopt the lifestyle of Srila Gurudev, Srila Guru Gobind Maharaj, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktivedanta Vaman Gosai Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Gosai Maharaj, all our acharyas, if we read their biography of the hear about them, the greed dwellers. Can one day I can follow them? Can this day will come in my life? I will follow them. Greed. And this is called association. So when we hear from them, we hear their lecture, the association comes. There was a devotee who saw, I saw him last year. He said, I was into very deep, some materialistic ideas was troubling me a lot. With my anger, with my greed, with my lust, all these things. He said, but once upon a time, I was just scrolling and I saw on YouTube one lecture of Srila Guru Gobind Maharaj, and how heavy he was roaring like a lion. Say, when I heard this 1 hour lecture, I heard this, my everything, all this negativity went far away. Why? Because his powerful speech, Satang Prasangam Mam Virja Samvido. That powerful speech entered my heart and took out that negativity from my heart. Or in other words, I feel greedy to adopt his lifestyle into my lifestyle. I got association. I said, I've become so good. For 1 month, this battery recharged. For 1 month. And then I got this click. Every time when I feel weak, I should hear lectures of Srila Gurudev. We have so much time. In the morning, every morning one lecture, 30 minutes, 15 minutes, something in the morning. So to develop this greed. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri Krishna, internal cause is to taste that greed. You see, adoption of someone's lifestyle, even Krishna. What is the form of Mahaprabhu? The form of Mahaprabhu is what? It's just simple definition, association. When Krishna wants to associate with the moods of Radharani, when Krishna wants to associate with the complexion of Radharani, Krishna becomes Mahaprabhu. And then he becomes Mahavadanyai, the great donor. Because Radharani is great donor. Karuna, Karuna Mai, Karuna Bharite. All compassionate one. Full of mercy. Heart is so soft. Can't see the pain and suffering of others. And that's why Krishna wants to associate with the mood of Radharani. You see, this is called association. So the form of Mahaprabhu is what? The association of Krishna. With whom? With his superior. Radharani is superior to Krishna. And Krishna adopted the lifestyle of Radharani. And the moment he adopted, his life changed. What is his life change? Try to understand my point. He promised in Bhagavad Gita, Ye yatha mam pravadante tam sate bhajamiham. I reciprocate you in the same proportion, in the same degree as you worship me. This is his promise. So this was his lifestyle. Although Rupa Goswami Pad told in Bhakti Swami Sindhu, Santavatar bahuva pankaj navasya sarvatva bhadra Krishna vadanya kova latosi premado bhavati. Rupa Goswami Pad explains, who can be more generous than Krishna, who gives his love even to the creepers in Braj. Yeah. Giving love to the creepers. But who are these creepers? These creepers are not ordinary creepers. They already established. They are in Braj. They are already established there. So Krishna is sprinkling his loving reciprocation from Radharani to all these creepers. So they got blessed. That's why he's what? He's Karuna. He's compassionate. He's generous. Yeah. But when Krishna saw Radharani is more generous, he adopted the lifestyle of Radharani. And then he became, from Vadanya, he became Mahavadanyaya. From Vadanyaya, he became Mahavadanyaya. So Mahaprabhu is Mahavadanyaya. So this is some details of Radha Tattva. So Gaur Tattva is incompatible with Radha Tattva, actually. Because it cannot, Gaur Tattva cannot be complete if there is no discussion about the glories of Radharani. See? Therefore, these three desires are all related to Radharani. So we must discuss Radha Tattva, Maharaj explains. Otherwise, you cannot understand it. It is very difficult Tattva. Therefore, Krishna has become greedy for it. He has developed three types of greed or three types of desires. He tries his best to fulfill his greed in Krishna Leela. He tried his best, but he could not. Therefore, that greed is there in the heart, and it is very, 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 very intense greed. Krishna tried when he manifested his Krishna Leela to satisfy his greed, but was not able to accomplish this. Why? Why not? Vishay jati sukh amar halad, ama hoite koti gun ashre halad, ashre jati sukh paite manadhai, yatna swadite nari ki kari upai. Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami explains in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishna says, Vishay jati sukh amar halad. I am the object of worship. Vishay jati. Vishay jati sukh amar halad, ama hoite koti gun ashri halad. Krishna said, but I see million time more what I am relishing, what I am getting bliss. I am seeing the ashri jati, those who are subject of worship, means Radharani. She is relishing million time more than me. So ashri jati sukh paite manadhai. Krishna said, my heart is earning for receiving or getting what she is going through. Ashri jati sukh paite manadhai, yatna swadite nari ki kari upai. Krishna said, I am trying so much as Krishna, but failure, I cannot. So these three greeds of Krishna cannot be fulfilled in Krishna Leela. He tried his best, but he could not. And this greed remained in his heart. And very intense greed, which cannot be suppressed. Krishna cannot suppress this. It is very intense. It's growing and growing and growing. But it must be fulfilled. What shall I do? Krishna is thinking, what shall I do? How to fulfill these three desires or three types of greed? Having thought about this very deeply, at last Krishna decided. He's thinking. And he decided, I must assume the mood and complexion of Radharani. Otherwise, I cannot fulfill these three desires. I repeat again. I must assume the mood and the complexion of Radharani. Otherwise, I cannot fulfill these three desires. These desires are not fulfilled in Krishna Leela. These desires are fulfilled in Gaura Leela. Therefore, Krishna has appeared as Gaura. So this is the internal cause. External is, repeating again, Nam Sankirtan, helping others, But internal cause is helping his own self, tasting, relishing. He wants to do his own. Therefore, these three desires got fulfilled only in Gaura Leela. Therefore, Avatar Sar Gaura Avatar Keno Na Bhaji Nuami. In the song book, there is a song which says, Avatar Sar, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the essence of all the avatars. Gaura Avatar. So, what that love of Radha is, and how Radha love is very great, even greater than Krishna, this we need to discuss. What is that again? What is that love of Radha? And why it is greater and greater than Krishna? So Srila Maharaj explains here. Krishna has said in Bhagavad Gita, Matta Paratram Nanyat Kinchid Asti. There is no one superior to me, Krishna said. What to speak of anyone equal to Krishna? No one. No one can be even superior to Krishna. Krishna boldly claims in Bhagavad Gita, no one can be superior to me. So Krishna is supreme. But here Krishna is not supreme. Very interesting topic. Krishna is supreme. There is no one beyond Krishna. He is Govindam Adi Purusham Tamam Bhajami. He is Anadir Adir Govind Sarvakaranam Karanam. He is the cause of all causes. He has no cause. But he is the cause of all other. Yeah. So he is supreme. But on the other hand, the other part of the coin is, he is not supreme. He is not supreme. Then who is supreme? If he is supreme, then why he is requesting the lotus feet of Radharani, saying, Dehi Padapallav Udaram Sumaragarla Khandanam Mama Shirisi Mandanam Dehi Padapallav Udaram. O Radharani, please get satisfied. Krishna pacifying Radharani by placing his peacock feather, by placing his flute, which is his best instrument or best weapon, in the hands of Krishna. He's offering at the lotus feet of Radharani. So how he can be supreme then? Then who is supreme? Say, Radharani is supreme. That's why these are two opposite things. This is very wonderful. Krishna is saying, I am supreme in Bhagavad Gita. He is saying I am supreme, but when he acts, his action says he is not supreme. Because he is falling, keeping his peacock feather and flute and the lotus feet of Radharani, then how he can be supreme? Then that means Radharani is supreme. So this is like two opposite things. And that makes this interesting topic. The three topics in Radha Prem. You will find three topics in Radha Prem. What is first? First is, Radha Prem makes Krishna mad. This is the story of a mad person, not an ordinary mad person. And it's not an ordinary madness. This is the madness of Supreme. People are mad in this world for different reasons. Intoxication, mad. For money, mad. For greed, mad. There is no limit of madness. Unlimited madness. But in the spiritual world, the Supreme Lord, who is self-satisfied, he don't need anybody else, he gets mad. Mad in what? To understand. What is Radha's Prem? What is the love of Radharani? Radha Prem is so powerful that it makes Krishna, who is almighty and all-powerful, completely mad. Very interesting. Krishna himself says this. In Chaitanya Chaitamit, Adi Leela, Na jane Radha Prem ache koto bal, সেই বলে আমা সদা করে বিবল আই ডোন্ট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড হাউ মাচ স্ট্রেংথ ইজ দেয়ার ইন রাধা রানীস লাভ সে বলে আমা করে সদা বিবল আই গেট বিবিল্ডার্ড টু সি হোয়াট ইজ দ্যাট প্রেম দ্য গ্লোরিস অফ প্রেম অফ রাধা রানী ইভেন দো ইজ অল মাইটি ইভেন দো ইজ পাওয়ারফুল বাট ই গেটস ম্যাড Krishna is all powerful, almighty, and omnipotent. Yet he becomes mad for Radha Prem. So, hence proved, Radha Prem is greater than Krishna. Who's greater? He's not saying Radha is greater. She is, of course. But Radha Prem is greater than Krishna. And Krishna become greedy. For this is one. Number two is that the pleasure and happiness derived from relishing the mellow of that love, Radha Prem, is unknown to Krishna. You understand my point? Krishna is not familiar what Radharani goes through. Relishment. When she sees me, when she hears my flute song, when she adores my beauty, what is that she goes through? Make Krishna restless. I can't. Even I'm Krishna. I cannot understand this, what she is going through. It is unknown to him. Unknown to him means unknown to whom? Unknown to that person who is all knowing. Very strange. Krishna is all knowing, but he don't know what is the gravity of Radha's prem. You see? So first point we heard, Krishna is almighty, all powerful, and superior. But something more than superior to that is Radha's prem, more powerful than Krishna. The second point we heard, just heard, the pleasure and happiness which Radharani derived by with Krishna, that love, that Radha prem, is unknown to that all-knowing one, unknown to Krishna, who is all-knower. He knows everything in the heart of everyone. He is Paramatma. Sitting in the heart of everyone, he knows. Yeah. But he also don't know what is Radha Prem. Second point. The third and the last point is that there is a combination of two opposite in Radha Prem. One after another, we will discuss these topics, Maharaj explains. The first topic is how Radha Prem makes Krishna mad. When a question of madness comes, we should analyze what the reasons may that be a person becomes mad. When we discussing the subject madness, one should analyze what is the reason which makes a person mad. There are three reasons. There are three reasons. What are three reasons? So again, question. What are the reasons that a person becomes mad? There are three reasons. Do you know them? Are you not mad? A madman does not know that he's mad. A mad person does not know he's mad. You ask any mad person. You just try to ask him, are you mad? What he will say? I don't know. So number one is when someone thinks about one topic or subject matter very deeply, then he becomes mad. This is first reason. When someone thinks about one topic or subject matter very deeply, then he becomes mad. Oh, really? There's a new phone came in the market, iPhone 10. Oh, really? And one goes too deep into that subject, becomes mad. I want to get this phone. Oh, with this facility, we can connect as many people in the world through Harikatha. Really? Very excited, becomes mad. So this is the first reason. Number two is that each individual has a capacity to contain something. Every individual has their own capacity to contain something. A container has a fixed capacity. For example, the capacity of 60 watt tube light or bulb can only burn 60 watt. But if the frequency grows to 100 watt, what will happen? It will blast. That means it becomes mad. You understand? I repeat again. We have this bulbs, and it says on the bulb is written 60 watt. Means the bulb can only hold 60 watt of electricity. And if electricity goes 100 watts, what will happen? Blast. Means the bulb become mad. So one is, if someone thinks about one topic or subject very deeply, then he becomes mad. Another is, second point is, one whose container to hold something, and if so much is there, it blasts, becomes mad. The third reason is, if a person does not have sufficient knowledge about some subject matter or some topic, when his knowledge is covered with ignorance, then he becomes mad. Understand? I repeat again. The third reason is, if a person does not have sufficient knowledge, if you don't have sufficient knowledge of any subject matter or some topic, and the knowledge is covered by ignorance, the person becomes mad. Yeah, these are three reasons why one gets mad. So we will analyze one after another whether these reasons are applicable to Krishna or not. But when we analyze them, you will find that these three reasons are not at all applicable to him. Not applicable to him. Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. Ete chas kalapumsam krishnastu bhagwan swayam. He is completely full. He is purna brahma, purna brahma. Everyone meditates on him, everyone glorifies him, all analyze Krishna tattva deeply, all inquire increasingly about him to understand him completely. Still, it is very difficult. All are absorbed in the thought of Krishna, Jagannath, because he is the absolute truth. Advay Gyan Tattva Purna Brahm, completely full, Apta Kam, self-satisfied, Atma Ram, who enjoys in his own self. He is the source and reservoir of all the mellows, Raso Vaisa. Is the source of all the mellows, all the rasas. He is Paramananda Sarup, means supremely Anandamay. Ananda Abhyasad, Vedan Sutra says, he is supremely full of bliss. And that is the meaning of the word Krishna. The word syllable Krishna divide into two parts. Krishna. Krish means Krishi Bhuvachuka Shabda Nacha Nivritta Vachaka. Krish means complete opulence, and Na means complete bliss. So Krishna is supreme bliss, anandamay. So how will it be that he will think of some subject matter or topic very deeply and become mad? It is impossible. Understand? Krishna's Supreme Personality of Godhead is Purna Brahma. He enjoys in all self. He don't need anybody else. He's supreme. So how will it be possible he will think of some subject matter or topic very deeply and becomes mad? It is impossible. Therefore, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in Chaitanya Charitamrita says, Krishna vichar ek ache antare, purnanand purna rase roop kahe more. Once Lord Krishna considered within his heart, because Krishna is thinking in his heart, everyone says that I am complete bliss, full of all rasas. Ama haite anit anandit hai tribhuvan, ama ke anand dibe eche kon jan. But all the world derives pleasure from me. The whole world derives pleasure from me. Is there anyone who can give me pleasure? Krishna is thinking. Who can give this? Ama haite yar hai shat shat gun. Sei jane aladite pare mor man. One who has 100 times more qualities than me could give pleasure to my mind. This is Chaitanya Charitamrita, Adi Leela. These are Krishna's thought. So I am ending up for this time by concluding the words saying, Krishna thinks, Purnanand Purna Ras Rupa Kahe More. All say that I am supremely complete and reservoir of all mellows. There is no incompleteness or deficiency in me. I am supremely anandamay, blissful. The three planetary system becomes blissful on account of me, because of me. Is there anyone who can give me pleasure? I am the source of pleasure. Everyone derives pleasure from me. But is there anyone who can give me pleasure? This is a question mark. Is there anyone who can give me pleasure? I give pleasure to one and all throughout the three planetary system. I am Paramananda, Supreme Ananda. Is there anyone who can give me pleasure? Ananda. This is a question mark. So next time we will continue with this, hearing more what is the madness of Krishna and who can give the complete anand and pleasure, means the bliss, to Krishna. Who can give this? Although we know this, but how it has to be related. We all know it's Radharani, as I mentioned earlier. का कृष्णस्य प्रणय जनिभू श्रीमती राधिका एक. Only Radha Rani, no one else. Only Radha Rani. But how she is doing this? What is her mood towards Krishna and Krishna towards Radha Rani? There are many, many more details. So we're going to hear this in our next session. All of you, thank you so much. Gracias. Obrigado. Danke vos. All the devotees. Hare Krishna.